Well, we're here. Welcome home.
Clint and I spent 9 weeks together. He's a great guy. Not only did he help me find my footing in the new job, but he also gave me a fresh perspective of my self-worth. He taught me how to have more confidence, which for one reason or another, I'd always struggled to maintain. Clint provided me with the best training possible, showing me a number of useful tricks, and all the ins and outs of an 18-wheeler. We also talked about my father quite a bit. In Clint's words, he was a quiet guy, but opened up amongst friends. They were really close. Clint said my father talked about me all the time and took good care of my mom, trying to make sure we had everything we needed. He was working hard at keeping our family together until the tornado tore us apart. I got a job at Furious Delivery Company. Clint recommended me, and I hope we'll stay in touch with him. Now it's high time for me to make something of myself.
There he is, the son of a legend. How's it going, Nathan?
Can't complain. Thanks again for the opportunity.
Clint is the one you should be thanking. I don't really need any new drivers right now, but having Charles's son aboard is something else. Welcome to the team. This is James, our main dispatcher.
Nice to meet you, Nathan. I knew your father. He was a great man and a real hero.
Thanks. Where should I start?
Given your time spent with a veteran like Clint, and your success so far, we're tossing you right into the deep end. Construction materials.
Okay.
As you probably already know, we use all possible communication channels, including email. But as an old school dispatcher, I prefer voice communication.
I'll keep that in mind.
Thanks. I'll talk to you once you're in the truck to give you further instructions.
Sounds good. I'll get going now.
Leave sooner, drive slower, and live longer. Trucker's motto. Oh, and good luck.
Hi again.
Hey.
How's the machine?
It's a beast.
Glad to hear that. Now, back to business. Some construction materials need to be transported. The company is ZID. We're talking cement. 11.3 tons in total.
Yeah, no problem. What's the address?
The delivery is stored near Jamietown and must be delivered to the construction site near Oak Valley Farm.
Roger that.
I like how you communicate. It's like I'm talking to an experienced driver.
9 weeks with Clint will do that to you.
For sure. Listen, young man, take a word of advice, and I'll let you do your thing.
I'm listening.
Much like Clint, I'm old school myself. I mentioned it earlier.
Yeah.
In the future, you'll likely work with other dispatchers around your age or even younger. Today's dispatchers are rarely ex-truckers. Old school truckers like myself know what a driver deals with on a day-to-day basis. A present-day dispatcher is often just a kid with a computer. They mostly care what the software says and sometimes disregard the driver. But don't pick fights with them unless you're trying to give yourself a headache. They'll always want to be in charge of your schedule, but at the end of the day, you'll need to be on the same page. Just remember to never make any definite promises. Dispatchers are often pressured by the sales team, who give customers false promises themselves. But no matter what goods you get, you always say that you'll do your best to deliver them as instructed by the customer. Nothing more, nothing less. You have no way of knowing what could happen on the road. So no guarantees.
Thanks for the advice, James.
Huh. You still have a long way to go, young man. You're gonna face lots of challenges, and you'll make mistakes, which will either make you better trucker, or make you give up on this job forever.
I don't expect it to be easy.
That's good. Listen, we had a nice talk. I've got to go now. If you have any questions, speak up now or feel free to call me or email me later. Good luck.
Thanks. I'll talk to you later. Hello?
Hello, my son.
I'm listening, Mother.
I just wanted to check in. After all, it's your first day on the new job.
I've already got my first load. I'm on my way to drop-off location.
Oh, glad to hear that. Does that mean you're getting along with your coworkers?
Yeah, everything's fine, Mom. I'll come to see you after work.
Oh, well, what would you like for dinner?
Whatever. See you later. Ah, man. I was rude to my mom again. It's not good. Hey.
Hey, Nathan, are you carrying any dangerous goods?
Nah. I'm hauling gold from Fort Knox.
You the man. Do I get one or two bars?
For you? A truckload. What's up, my man?
Let's meet up.
Sure. Tomorrow?
Okay, cool.
I'll come with the truck straight after work. Actually, scratch that. Let's meet at Nomad. It'd be easier to park this beast there.
Perfect. See you there after 9?
Sounds good. Alright, bro. I'll see you later.
Yeah, bye. And be careful with all those gold bars.
Thank you.
Congratulations on completing your first order, Nathan.
Thanks.
Hey, Nathan, where are you?
What's up? I'm meeting at Rosalia.
Okay, listen, I've got an order. An urgent one.
I've got you. Go on.
Man, you're awesome. It's about TVs from the dock.
Blue Creek?
Yes, I tried some other truckers, but you're the closest.
The dock? Why from there?
Don't ask. I have no idea. There's some sort of Chinese knockoffs. The client called and said it was urgent. They're paying extra, so you'll get a bonus.
Where do I take them?
The mall in Valencia. It is important that you make it to the unloading point before 10 o'clock.
Okay. I'll be on my way shortly.
Keep me posted if any issues come up, Nathan.
10-4.